What's up, everyone? The Gotham Collector here, and today is going to be part 3 of building my Batsuit. So, yesterday I was able to finish the fins for the gauntlets. I don't know if you guys remember, last week I just did an overview talking about the build and the fins. I actually was wondering, should I do the brass color or the gold, but I like the brass color better, so I went with that. These are aluminum, and I actually finished them last night, but I had to paint them and let them sit. And today, after I got off work, I just weathered them a little bit, a couple of coats of clear coat, and this is the final product. I'm super happy how it turned out. I used the same color as the pouches for the belt, so they're matching. The only difference is that I clear coated this one. This one is not yet, but I will eventually. I'm just waiting for the flat clear coat, because I don't want the belt buckle, I don't want the cylinders and pouches to be sparkly, not sparkly, you know what I'm talking about, flashy and glossy. But yeah, so those are the fins. I'm really happy how they turned out, and as I told you guys, because we're trying to make it real, these are aluminum. They're not going anywhere. I try to make them as symmetrical as possible. I know there's some differences, but whatever. They're gonna be on display anyways most of the time. The only thing what I would do is, because I was gonna order the gauntlets probably from Ninko Creations, or I'll see. Those are the ones I like the best, to be honest. I will see if he can send me the gauntlets and the fins separate, not attached. So that way, if let's say I go out to do a cosplay or something, I can put the urethane fins. But as I said, for my Batsuit, I'm planning to have it on the display like it's in the Batcave and Batman v Superman. I'm gonna make the stand with the lights and everything. That's just, as I said, that's my favorite suit of all. And I'll just switch them around. So what I was thinking is I'll probably get some leather straps, and let's say I'm wearing the suit right now, so the fabric comes to here. I'll get this, and let me just show you guys. Look, they're the perfect size for me. And even on this one, boom, and they're super sharp too. I don't have, let me see if I can find them. I just need a tissue, I guess, even though tissue doesn't make a difference, but not going. And I tried on cardboard, and it does pierce it and everything. Not that I'm gonna use it for a weapon, just as I said, want to make it as close as possible to the real thing. But yeah, later on I'll probably just get leather straps, have the suit on, wrap this with the leather straps on my forearm. And then, because most of the gauntlets, they come with a zipper, I'll just feed this through the hole to the side and zip them up. Because I was thinking of making, getting another one of those and make it like that with actual screws right here, like in the movie. But that was, I don't think that would be sturdy enough. And it might actually, if it's hanging on the urethane, not on my forearm, it might rip the gauntlets. And as you guys know, those gauntlets go for $250, $300 plus. So I'm not trying to damage those. But these ones, I was actually like, I'm really happy how it turned out. Like, they really look like the Dawn of Justice gauntlets. And look, shit. They're like super sharp, pointy and everything. These lines, like the way I was going for, I wanted to make them dirty, but I don't want to make the build dirty. I don't know if that makes sense, but I might. But like, I like the build looking clean and the gauntlets to be like, not damaged, but like, just like, I put like a little bit of shoe polish here and there, like just like not muddy, but just from use, you know. And I was actually thinking of getting my Dremel and make it battle damage, because it will show the aluminum color underneath after you clear coat it. So it'll be like you'll be able to see the actual metal on the inside. But like, I like them like that for now. Later on, I might change it a little bit. And these are the other ones. And there's like, as I said, two clear coats, but I might get them a little bit even more dirty. I just wanted to show you guys so you guys know what's going on. That's why I didn't upload a video yesterday, because I was working on those. And in here, I wanted to make it look like it was like welded, and like in my mind, these are like his first gauntlets, and he just put something together real quick for a day or two. But at the same time, they feel like you're wearing a tank, because you know, like, they're menacing. It's, as I said, this, look at this thing. It's like super sharp. And even yesterday, because I mean, if you guys are planning on doing, making yourself a pair, I'll say be very careful, because yesterday I was using, because I sharpened these on a build sander, but then I wanted to smooth the surface, so I was using those round ones, like an orbital sander thing, and I was holding with my right hand, and I had only one of those small ones, and I was holding it like that, kind of, I don't remember, before I attached the whole thing, and I was sanding it. And the way that thing was turning, it literally flew and it hit my safety goggles. And good thing I was wearing goggles, because that shit would have fucked me up. But yeah, like, I don't know, like, if you're young or whatever, I don't want anyone to get hurt, and I'm not like a professional welder and like craftsman and blah blah blah. I just use my imagination. I've never made any gauntlets or belts in my life. That's like, I mean, this is my second one, but I've never made gauntlets. This is my first time. And they're super light too. That's why I went with aluminum, because the stainless steel ones, probably one of them was heavier than the whole thing. This is like super, super light. And like, I even left it like that on the inside, like in the bottom. I didn't want to paint it, but I'm in love with these things. Like, look, it's crazy. And the color matches later on, one day when the suit comes, because I'm not ordering it now because of the coronavirus and stuff. And I don't want to spend $1,300 for a suit, but it'll be dope. It'll be dope. I'm super excited. But yeah, I wanted to share with you guys what I've been doing since yesterday, I guess, because I didn't upload a video. But yeah, we're waiting on the belt buckle. Hopefully, it will come soon. It was showing April 3rd to April 27th ETA, so the sooner the better, as always. But now, with, as I said in my previous videos, with the coronavirus, it might be delayed, but I don't care. Like, we just need to get rid of that fucking virus, because it's ridiculous. But yeah, this was part 3 of building my bat suit. and hopefully we'll have a part four soon when the belt buckle comes, and I will put the belt on for you guys, show you how it looks. But yeah, super happy with those bad boys. They look awesome. Like, let me give you like a little close up before. Like, you can even like look close up before I end the video. But yeah, and I actually like the glossy look to it on the gauntlets, to be honest. I'll probably hit them with a little bit of like shoe polish after, but yeah. Boom. And I like the Justice League ones too, because they're the same, but they're like just pointier. But that's like a little bit harder to make, but one day you never know. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Again, thank you to each and every one of you for supporting my channel, and I'm getting more and more views, and I really, really, really appreciate it. It does really mean a lot to me, and shout out to each and every one of y'all. Thank you for supporting me. If you guys have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I check my things all the time. Shout out to all of y'all. Stay safe, be healthy, and until next time, have a good one, guys.